In this lesson, we will learn about data types in VBA. We have here a macro named main. The variable height is assigned the number 5, the variable y is assigned the string I like pizza, and then a message box will appear that will display the value of height. Variables are automatically created when they are used in a statement. The statements height equals 5 and y equals I like pizza creates two variables named height and y. The variable height contains a number and the variable y contains a character string. In general, variables can contain many different types of data, such as integers, numbers with decimals, strings, and logical data. By default, VBA will automatically choose a data type for all the variables you create, but this can lead to some major problems. If we run the macro, the value stored in height, which is 5, appears in the message box. Let's say we want to change the value stored in height to 24 later in the program. When we run the code, we see the value of height has changed to 24. But what if we accidentally omitted the letter T? And then ran the program. We see the value of height is still 5 instead of 24. What happened is that another variable called high was created. It was assigned the value of 24, and the value of the variable height was never changed. We did not receive an error message since our code is technically correct. We have not broken any VBA rules, but our program is not doing what we want it to do. As your programs become longer and more complicated, these type of errors will become more frequent. Fortunately, we can avoid these errors by using the Option Explicit statement at the top of every module. Option Explicit forces you to declare the data type of all variables manually before using them in your code. For example, if we add option explicit to the beginning of this module, and then run the code, we get an error message stating that the variable height is not defined. This means that we have not declared our variable in the program. We must specify a data type for each variable before our code will execute properly. We declare a variable using the dim statement before we use the variable in the program, and usually variables are declared immediately after the name of the macro. After submain, we will type dim height as double, comma, y as string. The word dim tells the program we want to declare variables. Height as double declares the variable height as a double variable. Height will only be allowed to store numbers with decimal points. Y as string declares the variable y as a string variable, and y will only be allowed to store character strings. Now when we go and run the program, we receive an error message stating the variable high is not defined. This gives us a clue that maybe we made a mistake in our program. We can go to the source of the error message and fix the error. We add the letter T to the variable high and rerun the program. We do not receive an error message, and the value of height has successfully been changed. We can make every module automatically start with option explicit by selecting Tools, Options, and checking the box that states Require Variable Declaration. Now every module you create will automatically start with option explicit, and you'll be forced to declare all variables you use in your macros. although you are not required to use option explicit, it is strongly suggested that you do so in order to prevent the type of error shown in this example. Spending 1 or 2 minutes declaring variables at the beginning of your macros can prevent many hours of debugging code later on. There are many different data types in VBA. In this lesson, we will discuss 4 of the most commonly used data types. You've already seen 2 data types, double and string. A variable is declared using the dim statement, followed by the variable name, the word as, and the data type desired for that variable. We can declare 1 or more variables per dim statement and can have multiple dim statements per macro. For numerical data, we can create variables that store only integers or variables that can store real numbers that have decimal points. For variables that store integers, the integer data type is common. And for variables that store numbers with decimals, the double data type is common. Whenever a variable is declared, a certain amount of space is set aside in memory for that variable. Since the amount of memory is finite, we cannot store numbers with infinite precision. For technical reasons, integer variables can store integers ranging from around negative 33,000 to around positive 33,000. If you try to store a number outside of this range in an integer variable, you will receive an error message. Double variables can store numbers with up to 15 digits of precision, which is more than enough for any engineering application. For negative numbers, double variables can store values in the range of approximately negative 1.8 times 10 to the 308 to negative 4.9 times 10 to the negative 324. If you try to store a number more negative than negative 1.8 times 10 to the 308, you'll receive an error message. If you try to store a number smaller than negative 4.9 times 10 to the negative 324, the number will be converted to zero. For positive numbers, double variables can store values in the range of approximately positive 1.8 times 10 to the 308 to positive 4.9 times 10 to the negative 324. If you try to store a number greater than 1.8 times 10 to the 308, you will receive an error message. If you try to store a number smaller than 4.9 times 10 to the negative 324, the number will be converted to zero. Character strings are stored in variables with the string data type. You may store between 0 and approximately 2.1 billion individual characters in one string variable. Logical data are stored in variables with the Boolean data type. A Boolean variable can only store the value of false or true. Remember that using option explicit forces you to declare all your variables in your programs. It is highly recommended that you use option explicit, as it likely will prevent you from making many time-consuming mistakes.